Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the ACL 2015 Sydney Grand Final for Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. Bioasa joined by Dr. Curry here and two massive teams going head-to-head. Of course, Plantronics Mindfreak up against that Trident COD team. And right now, it's a close series. Obviously, it is still. It's 4-2 in favour of
A little
of
bit close.
In favour of Mindfreak. But still, you know, Trident can bring this one back and get it closer and closer, bit by bit, map by map, if they can. All the players are ready and good to go. So we're going to be heading to this one. Now, it was a continuation series to kick things off. 3-1 in favour of Mindfreak. Mindfreak picked up that S&D on Terrace. So, of course, making it 4-1. After that great uplink bilab game there for Trident, taking it by 1.8-7. Now, during the second half, it was Trident who scored 6 points. Only 4 points went in favour there for Mindfreak. Let's sort of see how that played out. And then we saw that 8-7 scoreline. So now, like we said, the series score, 4-2.
Yeah, Dens went really big in that biolab. Not only top scored for kills for his team, the only one going positive, but also had the most captures was the uplink, 5 to his name. So also doing the slaying and the OBJ work. Sensational Dens, as they love to call him. Into the map we go. It will be a hard point. What is going to go on, though? I was just about to say, you know, like a little bit of a prediction, but they've been off. It's been a surprise this entire grand final so far.
It was a bit, and you'll see a standard set up there from the Mindfreak squad. You know, fighter inside of towers, like I called it. You're going to have Shox in that backhand corner as well. Just to try and get his first points. 2 out of 2 there for Shox. Tries to hightail it out and recover a little bit there while his teammates came back off. They've got to watch out for this spawn flip. If Trident get it, which they are trying to force right now, it could be very damaging to the Mindfreak squad. And you'll see, you notice there on the minimap, I think they may have gotten it for a second, but thanks to the team of Mindfreak, aware that what was going on, they spun back around on their own, and they've now split the spawns, but it's all a bit of sporadic as Trident again now grab the spawn they wanted.
Just back and forth kills going between these two teams. They're just fighting right now, and they both do have a nice hearty amount of points to their name. Fighter looks like he's going to lock this one down for the final 10 seconds, and the rotation comes in towards the open turtle area. Buzzo already set up with that bow, but here comes a Trident player is going to use those tactical grenades to their advantage. No stuns coming in, actually. Jarzan outguns Buzzo, long range, picking up the headshot there. But here come those frag grenades, stopping them and trying to break the hill there. Very well done. Back and forth between these two teams, just trading it out. Yet Mindfreak still have that point advantage.
Oh, Buzzo getting a lot of takes in there. Couldn't finish off the kill. His teammate, though, of Dens will. Buzzing up high, watching from that crow's net. Like a guardian angel, that he is. Trying to pick up those shots and kills. He'll find no one. Bomber player pushing the corner there, but his teammate of foe was sneaking around behind him. Two players inside the hill. Dens comes in, making short work of him, and like that, Mindfreak clean house. Grab that hill, get a bit of control, and a plus 20 lead.
Yeah, very well done. They just suffocated the hill there and got all the picks and the kills. Shox now going to give support to his team. He's going to get those long-range ASM one-shots in. Gets one, gets two, can't get the third. That's going to be Jarzan Fighter. Can he redeem his teammate's death? It looks like he won't. That's huge by Jarzan, but he does eventually drop it. That two-piece just delaying Mindfreak ever so slightly. Here comes the third rotation in towards the lobby hardpoint. Damage wants to lock down these back cave spawns as well as he can, so he's going to hang back with the bow, try catch up a few of the Mindfreak players. Now he did spot Dance, and there's also going to be Buzzo, so they're both going to push him. Really shaky shots, picks off one and using the rock as cover. Lucky to get those ones.
Yeah, after those shots, Dens really shouldn't have got a kill at all. He should have been cleaned up, but he somehow managed to stay alive. And like you said, they are trying to hold that that back spawn in that cave and a gym side. And thanks to Dens staying alive, they've managed to do that. Four players now will swarm the hill here from Trident. They want to try and close that gap because it is, from looks at it, a 41-point game in favor of Mindfreak here. And they are closing it bit by bit, second by second. They've got a clean outside this lobby, though. A few players out and around. Fighters going to pick up that two-piece to help them clean house from the Mindfreak side as Shox just keeps it contested and keeping their lead safely how it was before. Finds damage inside. A few players at the back. He's aware of it. His teammates are out there sleeping as well. And 9 seconds left. You're going to see that rotation now happen down towards Cafe.
Look at Shox just being a monster right now. Has 14 kills to his name. Dens, two more than him on the 16th. Fighter hasn't hit it up too much. We haven't mentioned him throughout this series. Hasn't made too many monumental plays. Let's see if he can do it. They have a very healthy lead. The team of Mindfreak has Trident. Going to be trying to do the best they can to lock down the bar hardpoint, but they don't have control of the open area of the map. Chilling zone. Nice little two-piece. Can he get the third one? Last play is going to be inside the hill, but they will pre-fire around the corner. Cleans them up. Damage locking it down now. They do finally have control of open. As I say that, though, Buzzo, aggressive with the bow, works out quite well. It's nearly a 70-point advantage here for the team of Mindfreak. They're doing extremely well at outslaying and just getting those hills.
Yeah, you know, I was trying to show Triton some love there on stream, trying to find a player who was going to stay alive a little bit longer and help the guys out. But every single player I found were getting cleaned up by a nade or some random shots from behind at that point. So they've got to try and push up here. They realize that they need to break this hill because of the fact that Mindfreak are running away a bit point by point. And I did mention this before the map even started, that you know, yep. This is Mindfreak more of a good map for them. They know the rotations. They know what needs to be done to win it, and they've done it plenty of times. You'll see that 114 to 45 second. The hill will now rotate in towards here at Hotel, and a few players out and around there, but right now damage from the Trident team up high, watching front door.
Just going to use the grenades very well. There, four of them just got thrown out, stopping Dens from pushing in and also cleaning him up. Trident, three of them in the kill feed there as they do push out Mindfreak ever so slightly, but they got those nice alley spawns, so they're going to be able to flank in from multiple routes. Damage. Exo's around the corner after he gets a kill, but they're doing quite well at outslaying there. There is one player lurking, fighter, got the two-piece. He wants to try and contest the hill here. Damage, he knows he just could be any which direction whatsoever, and Mindfreak, well played by them to get that hill.
That was a big hill there over Trident. They got a fair few points out of that, and they did close that gap reasonably well compared to what it was before. But right now, Mindfreak have broken it. They've got a good 20 seconds left to have out of that if they can keep these guys from trying to bay. And Shox, it seems to be making very short work out of it. Few players around him. Buzzin picks up one as well. It's going to be four players down. Fires up there. Shox is getting set for this next part of the hill rotation. So Mindfreak in a bit of a lead right now. We're going to go into a listen-in with the Mindfreak team now. Let's just see what their comms are like. Thanks to Astro. Here we go.
He's tagged. Wait, I'm just gonna bait then.
Oi, what's he got? There's two in the hill.
Can you guys shoot him in the back or what?
Yeah.
He tagged. Bucket corner still. I got him. Last guy.
One shot.
Tails left side.
No.
Gate corner.
Wait, one's lobby.
Top circle. I tagged him. I'm in.
I'm in. Two
right next to me, Tails.
He's on.
Me,
Tails.
Do we flip out?
Yeah, I'm still Jim. Can't see Tails.
He's buckets.
Yeah, I'm just holding this corner then. Nice.
Fuck lobby.
Yeah. Let's go short. Wait, one's long.
Back long. Mating two.
One.
One more. Short way.
Dead.
Nice.
Tag on. You should be able to get him in the back.
Dead. Nice. One shot.
Spawning grass.
Pull jump. One more pull jump. Oh, he's in lobby. One's in lobby, yeah?
Yep. I'm going.
Get top lobby.
Three down, last guy on.
Cool, calm, collected communication from the boys at Mindfreak, and they need to keep that going because the guys from Trident, they're slowly clawing their way back into this one, getting some very vital points here, and it's only a 50-point deficit when it was upwards of 80 at one stage.
Yeah, we say that though, but Dens is just chilling here, laying on his back, catching a bit of rays there, a bit of a tan as well. A few players of Trident trying to come in. His teammates were helping him out and keeping them at bay. 167 to 114. Fighter just comes in, making short work the ASM one of all players, every which way around him. And realistically, just taking that hill back for the Mindfreak squad. Now, they will head over now to lobby, and it would seem to try another one set up for it. Spawn-wise, though, we can see a player of Mindfreak. It's going to be Fighter, who's trying to break it.
Yeah, long-range shot there by Dens. Very well job to throw them into the spawns there, but we'll be trying to locking it down. Here comes Buzzo contesting it. Happy to just let the clock go down, and they did actually get control of it here. If they can get a majority time, at least 30 seconds, you'd expect this one to go down to the wire. Dens, what can he do? Wants to break in, what's about? Picks off one. There's going to be a second player XO-ing towards him, but he's not going to be able to clean it up. Drops in the end there. Shocks, though, for Mindfreak. Can't do much there, as it's just going to be trading the kills back and forth. It was Mindfreak who were holding it. Damage, can he get the spawn to the back? He does. Got support from his team, but it's just a contest. Tested hill, 25 seconds remaining on it. Yeah. Looks like Trident won't be able to hold on to it.
Yeah, they've got to try and close that gap bit by bit. Now, so mathematically, they still have that time to do so. You know, it's only that 60-second deficit that they're in, so they've got 120 seconds in total game time now to answer back with. And you'll just see there, damage just lacing into Buzzard, who was trying to hop, skip, and a jump around. It wasn't going far, though, as look at that kill feed. And for the KDs, you know, you've got Shocks almost dropping a 40 bomb now. He's the highest up there. But two of the players from the Mindfreak team over 30. You've got two players from Trident on 30s and 21 there for Chillians and Beaston on 26 and 36. So all going fairly large. Buzzing a little bit lesser there, but the rest of the team guys, his teammates are going obviously very strong.
Ooh, Buzzing doing quite well for his team as you do see them trading out. he's just been a consistent player, just getting those long-range bow shots, locking down the spawns. That's what Dent's been doing, but he loves to be aggressive with it. Nice little two-piece there, four down for Trident, forcing them into the spawns. Shocks can just sit on the 42 kills and the hill. He's got nine captures to it. Chilling, he's trying to break it as well as he can. That deficit, though, looks like it's going to be the end very shortly for Trident, unless they lock down every single second for the next minute. But if they're getting three-piece like that by the entire Mindfreak squad, you got to question whether or not they can get back into it.
Yeah, that was a good chance there for Jarzan and Damage to both go to town on a few of the Mindfreak players. Sadly, they couldn't trade off how they wanted to, and they couldn't break the hill how they needed to at that time. So it's going to be a 50-point game right now. So still, again, like I said, it's mathematically possible, but Trident have to dig very deep. They need to get inside that hill, otherwise it's going to be too little too late.
And you do see them trying to get control of the spawns. Jars and pushing up with that ASM1. Knows there's a few players from Mindfreak lurking around towards the turtle. Long range shots, gets the headshot tag, but won't be able to finish it off. And Buzzin breaks it with about close range before Chillians does take out Dens with 30 seconds remaining and a deficit like that. It looks like Mindfreak will walk away with their fifth map. They're just one map away from taking out this grand final. Valiant effort by Trident though, but they were never really into it. Mindfreak holding on to the lead ever since that first hill back 10 minutes ago.
Yeah, another 40 bomb now. Dens has just pushed his 41. Fighter on 36. I jumped over with Shox before because Shox was on 44 and it looked like he was about to go slaying, but he sadly couldn't get the kill. He got picked up. But when you got two players dropping 40 bombs up against a team like Trident, Trident are aware it's pretty much done, so they've stopped there now. 208 to 176. The score becomes 5-2 now in the series as we head into a S&D on Riot. Now, I called a 6-2.
Oh.
Yourself and Nakabo called a 6-3. So, prayers for Bio right now. Can he get no prediction right this weekend? It'll be a miracle if it happens. But 44 and 31 with 9 captures, I think that was, for Shox. So a big effort. That's what
I'll
look at that score. 9 captures for him. 9 captures for Fighter as well. Went 36 and 32. 6 for Dan, so 42 and 33. And then buzzing down there at 30 and 34 for 7 caps to his name. But on the other side of things, plenty of captures as well for the team of Shrine, but they just weren't getting the defense style. That's where you sort of see that drop off.
You must note too, Beaston on the bottom of the scoreboard, 0.74 KD. He had the captures, as you said, but he is a main slaying role on that Trident team. And if he's unable to really excel and at least drop a positive or neutral KD, you got to wonder what's going on with him. So hopefully he can lift his game a little, and they're going to need it because one map and it's done. That will be Mindfreak taking out first place and they'll be done for second. Cheeky little grin there by Dent. He knows that they're on the verge of taking out this grand final.
Just love it. Look at the camera. There's some good opportunities there for some daily Dens. I believe Naked will capitalize on all of those.
Oh, he's already onto it. You know he is.
You know he's going to be onto that. He's writing down what time that happened that in the match, that way he can find it again. But Dens in broadcast mode, so all way for him to get set up and ready. Obviously, they might change one or two things here heading into this one. But S&D on Riot, as we said, will be this one. It could be the final match. At the moment, let's recap here. So the S&D was 6-5.
It was close.
In favour of Mindfreak. You tried and it looked like they were going to take it.
Oh, yes. They were on track. They were up 5-3. And then all of a sudden, they lost. Mindfreak won an aggressive round, should I say. And then they were put on defence, won that one easy. And 3 rounds in a row, just like that, they got it.
There as well with the kills. So heading into that, with that knowledge, it should be a close one, obviously being an S&D again, but different map like Riot. It's hard to pick, but I'm still feeling that this should be Mindfreak to close it out here. And if so, my prediction will be right, so...
That's all you're worrying about, is a prediction.
Yeah, pretty much.
You have to be right.
Yeah, I get flamed on Twitter for being wrong with my prediction.
I'm used to it.
It's like,
I always
like,
get
what do you know, boy? You know nothing.
People should assume the opposite of my prediction. That's what's going to happen. Because I never get them on point, unfortunately.
It's a maniac who has the bad luck with predictions. Yeah. So whatever he predicts, you always go opposite.
Opposite it. Okay. I'm going to write that in my notebook then.
We didn't get a prediction from him, mate. We should have asked Manny for his prediction. That way we can just go against him. But you see there on your screens, for those that aren't aware, that is that Trident lineup. You don't know what players what. From right to left, you have Damage, Beaston, Chillians, and then down the end there, Jarzan. The Jarzan, of course, are one of the newest members to the squad as well. So just there, these guys getting set, ready for action. Dan's still in a bit of a waiting there to fix up his classes too. So we are still going to wait for him to get a recap. But I've had a great weekend so far. I want a quick little shout out to our sponsors here. Obviously, being Astro, thanks to that listener we had beforehand with their headsets and the mix amps and every which way we come in for the sound side. So Astro, one of the big sponsors here so far over the weekend. You see there, their A50s wireless, but of course the A40s being the ones they used here with their feature station well.
You've tried on the A50s. We gave them a crack just before the grand final for some promotion and stuff. Phenomenal headsets.
Oh,
so I would highly recommend you guys invest in them. Very comfy and... Very reasonable for what you get, what you want, and it's perfect. But there, they've been proud sponsor for the 2015 ACL Pro Circuit. Looks like we're good to go to get into the Search and Destroy on Riot Bio. I know you want your prediction to be accurate for obvious reasons, but what are your odds of trying to getting this one?
The odds of trying getting the map. Oh, I'm going to say it's probably about... It's a 50-50 because it was around 11 in that first S&D. I'm going to say it's a 50-50.
50-50?
Yeah, it's a 50-50.
Do you want to flip a coin, maybe?
They're trying to figure out who's going where, top or bottom.
Yeah,
it looks like
bottom,
it looks like Trident will go bottom, and of course that will be the defensive side. So the attack will go first for Mindfreak.
Okay.
I've learned that from playing fives.
So if it's 50-50, then you're going for my... Well, you'd assume you get the 50% for the Mindfreak. I have the 50% for Trident.
Okay.
Because it's two of us.
Yeah, I'll give you
math.
Good math is good.
Good math is good.
As we head into this one, like I said, it will be the Mindfreak team on the attack for the first round into this. And usually, of course, the A preferred bomb site for any team. But they might try and mix it up. They might even try and go for a quick mid push. But it doesn't seem to be the case. They will hit the A bomb hard and fast.
They did mix it up in the Terrace game. They were very aggressive then, very defensive on aggressive rounds and defensive rounds. Didn't really matter which side it was. They like to mix it up. It looks like they want to be aggressive on this aggressive round. Shocks draws first blood there. Long range. Both of them missing a fair few shots there. But he ends up triumphing over... Jarzan, who does drop numbers advantage for Mindfreak.
Jarzan's got a backtrack.
I was about to say, I was like, how come the bomb hasn't got it? They left it in spawn.
Look at this here, though. There's a player right above Shox, and Shox is just lying here and waiting for him to poke again. He knows that he's there, but he's worried about that back player there as well. He's obviously distracting away. One player pushes on up. Ooh, it was Beast in there. Shox now looking for more. He should be looking in that back courtyard. There's one player inside there.
Can't go on past him.
Tries to get on past. A Hail Mary nade comes out. The bomb has gone down, however. Becomes now a 2v3. Now a 1v3 here for damage after fight up down there on Chileans.
Oh, there's one.
A 1v2. Oh,
there's two.
1v1. He's right beside him. He sees it.
Oh, he
gets the shots.
Oh, my
gets the
God.
Twos.
What?
And the team of Mindfreak will be saying, what just happened? Damage happened with the ace, with the defuse. Big first round for Trident.
And just look at him. It's like, that's a normal day in the office for him. Cool, calm, collected. Absolutely incredible play. I can't believe it. It must be noted that grenade, the Hail Mary, tagged up two of those players, allowed him to drop them instantly. Wow. And he gets the ace too. Great job by Damage.
Big first round. Obviously, like you said, he was cool, calm, and collected. He wasn't moving at all. He has to stay focused because this is their last chance to stay in this one, obviously, and he's aware of it. Big Nate going out the back there. A little bit worried he's going to hit his teammate then. I think you were as well. But Jarzan's getting the bomb down. It should be down easily here. Now making it a 3v3.
Okay, very aggressive from Trident. They've got to be running off some momentum after that incredible clutch. Jarzan wants to rotate around, try to get control of the back basketball court. Damage drops another one. Five straight kills for him going off right now. As numbers advantage will be equal, and it looks like it's going to be trading out once again. So it's going to be Buzzo.
He doesn't actually get it.
The ASM one too strong there. Beast in. Can he be able to clutch this one with 17 seconds? You'd assume so. Just play the clock down. Beast and try and... Buzzo has to try and make a play right now. And he actually pushed out with 10 seconds. Pre-fast the bomb. Very well played. 2-0. Good start for Trident.
You know, I said it was 50-50, but right now it's looking a bit more 60-40 in favor of Trident here. With that second round now in their favor as well. So we'll see there in the final kill cam. Beaston picking that one up as again. And into the third round that will go with the momentum still in favor there for Trident. Obviously, they're feeling it. They're wanting it. And it all depends on how bad Mindfreak want to close it out because they have to pick up a round or two here. And Dens has to pick up a kill or two.
Dens, he had a poor performance in the first Search and Destroy, and it's a little concerning to see him going 0-for-2 already in the second one. Of course, just one map, as you said, away from winning the 2015 ACL Pro Call of Duty tournament.
You see here, there's Chilean side at the fire side, also inside mid-jails. A few players down around trying. Chileans will find the first kill there on Shocks. There is a player on that back right-hand side, and Dens was aware that he may be pushing. They found Chileans, who was on that backside. Dens does find that bomb. Buzzin and Dens in a 2v3 now. Damage making short work of Buzzin, though. Pops up high. Dens finds one. Gets tagged on the second. Doesn't finish him off, though. It is Damage who is over there. Damage. And Dens, the former Double D combo, now going at it head-to-head. Turns around. Finds one coming in through mid-stairs on Jarzan. It's a 1v1 now. Can Dens do what Damage did earlier and get the clutch in the round for the guys to put him on the scoreboard? He's pretty sure that he's wrapped around to B. So he's going to try and get there around there. Well, it looked like he was going to try and get there quickly, but he slowed it right down.
Dent playing this so well, and Damage, he nearly got taken out on that head glitch. So the fact that this is a one-on-one situation is almost remarkable. Denz, can he clutch this one up? It looks like damage has to rotate. He has 6 kills to his name. He's going off right now in the search and destroy. Can he get Trident half the rounds they need to win this one? And it looks like he's just going to be really passive.
Yeah, they're both
about
just waiting. Yeah. They're both waiting, hoping that one will poke the other. Oh, there's, he sees him there. He comes back, tracks
oh,
it.
Nice.
He'll get the kill and put Mindfreak on the board.
Huge.
2-1.
That was a 1v3. It needs to be noted. So, Denz, he gets his own clutch in that situation. The Hitfire ASM1, very effective at times. And it's effective this time as Denz clutches it, gets the first round on the board, and that was an aggressive round. So, they're on track to equal the scores here and go to 2-2 if they can win their defensive round now.
Yeah, that was big. Like you said, he got that clutch, but it was also the fact that he was on 0 kills before that. So, it's very big a momentum switch for him, mm-hmm. allowing him to get off that donut, gets a couple of kills for his name, and start pushing out and along. So, right now, again, we're here with damage. We're going to change to the Jarzan instead. Show a bit of love. He's pushing out quickly, and he did get hit with that stun. He has enabled his mute. He's got the double mute device at his exo side. He wants to try and be very, very sneaky as he gets this bomb down. You can see their fighter inside. Didn't poke for it, though. He's still just chilling outside. Bomber's down. Time is ticking. Yet a player to be dropped, though.
Jarzan, this is the second time he's been very aggressive and planted the bomb in quick concession. Beaston gets a kill on Buzz, though. Beaston also misses his second shot, but...
Oh, it's sniper on sniper.
No. Okay. Both of them just duke out at the same time. Denzo does get spotted. Well scoped there by Beast. An easy kill there. Fighter 1v2.
Tries to hightail it through fire there, but yeah, he couldn't get away. And he was pretty much going to run into Beaston, who was in the inside there at jail too. So it was sort of a bit of a bad situation. Be stuck between a damage and a Beaston.
That's not where you want to be.
No, it's not.
Nah, especially in the middle of the fire.
I'd rather be stuck between a rock and a hard place between those two players. But
absolutely.
3-1, the scoreline becomes, of course, the 2 rounds. The difference is now set. Of course, it's round 4, round number 5 up in here just a moment. Of course, Mindfreak back on that attack, but we saw this on Terrace as well. You know, we saw that the Trident team had that lead, and
yes,
then Mindfreak brought it back.
Exactly.
Can they do it?
I have to agree with you on that one, but what can Buzzer do? Warning shot. We'll count it as that, but expects a player to be pushing around the corner. It looks like it's not going to happen, but he's... he dies. That's going to be the 8th kill for damage, as Buzzer will drop numbers advantage for Trident. But it's interesting to note, Buzzer all the way looking over towards the opposite bond site while Shox was just trying to make his own play here. He doesn't have that much support from the rest of his team, so he has to come up clutchy and get a few kills. That's exactly what they needed. Fighter makes it a 3-on-3, but I like the positioning of the Trident player. Look how defensive that they're being in this situation. They are waiting for Mindfreak to poke around a corner, maybe not check it, and get a bit of a cheeky kill.
Yeah, obviously you see Shox over here on this A side. They were sort of feeling it might be, they might wrap back around to that B, obviously because Buzzin was there, but it was a split push to begin with. They do have one player over there, though. It's going to be Denz, and the shot's coming from behind. It's going to be Jarzan who finds Shox to just try and get that bomb down, so didn't have enough time to do it. Time is now ticking against the Mindfreak squad. You know, beasting up high and around. They're going to know the bomb was down there as well. 2-on-2 now, 1v2 as Demi finds Fighter. Denz now trying to get up against Damage and Beast, and he's got a player behind him. He walks right out in front of him. 4-1 now, the score becomes. It's going to be Trident still in that lead here.
Mm-hmm.
This is Mindfreak sort of last chance, I think. They've got to start getting a bit of a round, because even though they're not at 5 yet, I think if Trident do get to 5, it'll be too much for Mindfreak to come back then.
Well, if anyone can do it, you'd expect it to be Mindfreak. You know, they've been on top of the Australian Call of Duty scene for so long, even the New Zealand Call of Duty. New Zealand.
ANZ, mate.
Should I say ANZ? We'll count New Zealand with us. And they will be on the defensive round, so hopefully Mindfreak can get some rounds on the board. But when damage is going 9-2, you got to wonder what your options are.
Yeah, you do. I'm going to change a bit of beast just quickly here, though, just to see, because you got a two-player push, but it looked like a three-player was going to happen. Pushing up that third, wrapping around from B, and they know Beaston's there. They're trying to hightail it after him. The bomb down there at the A side should be getting planted any second now, unless he's just chilling there waiting. That looks like he was playing the bomb. Those players did stop that push. Dead pass across, tries to dash on out. Chillin's though in a good setup there to watch that mid cut to make sure they weren't going to try and wrap back too much and damage on that deep flank. Just watching and making sure that no one else is going to come through.
Very rare to see Chillin's using the bow, but he does get the kill in that situation. Fighter long range. Oh, tags up damage. Dead red. And Exo's around from the hit marker, but does drop from Beast. And Buzzo, last one alive in a 1v4 with 20 seconds left. Don't think he's going to get this one, but he does get a kill. So
I thought he was going to try and save just then instead of trying to challenge. But
this
he
isn't CSGO decided, by
yeah, it looked like he was going to, though. He's yes. like, I've got the snipe, guys. I'll head back into spawn. We'll just wait it out for that bomb to blow up and try and come back next round. But I'm not sure if he knew if it was CS or not.
You've been watching way too much CSGO. Of course, it was part of ACL Pro's lineup for this event, ACL Sydney 2015. course, we had the Invitational. Congratulations to Renegade. They're going to be going to ESL in a few months. So good luck for them. But right now, Trident on track to get this search and destroy and slow that momentum that Mindfreak have.
And I found that if Trident did get that last round, now it's just too much, and I don't think Mindfreak will get these next five in a row. But I'm happy if they prove me wrong and make my prediction right.
Okay.
That's all I'm going to say here and now. But the first kill goes out, and Shox is off to a good start for it. He'll find Chillians there, making it a 3v4. Of course, the bomb is now getting down. As you're seeing your screen. It's going to change over, though. Watch these other players who are pushing back. You got a good little setup here on the defensive side, but they weren't watching the bomb, and Beaston popped out to find Dan's on that bomb site.
Yeah, they can just run down the clock here, and they should be able to get their second.
Oh, Jarson, what are you doing?
Where did he come from?
I don't even know.
Oh, wow.
He knows where he came from.
Well, he's dead now, and shocked that will be his second kill for the round. That's going to be third. Can he actually get the ace here? Beaston, last one alive, runs into him. Shucks doesn't get the smackdown. Beaston gets one kill, and he drops. So no ace for Shucks, but he gets the round at least. Beaston, he doesn't mind too badly because they are up 5-2, just one round away.
Yeah, you can see that they were still pretty calm and collected.
They know that
this is still theirs to lose for this S&D, so they know they're still calm and collected. They know that it's they need one more compared to the four rounds that Mindfreak needs. So here's this next one. Of course, on the attack, Triton go again, and Demi's still having a great game. He's on 10-3 score point-wise. Chillian's 3-6. I feel if he got a few more kills, maybe they'd close this round out earlier off. So give him a bit of love. Show him on the stream and see if he can find one or two players that buzzing. Good start. And Dan's Mindfreak. Going digging deep right now. Pick up three players inside jails in mid there. Chillian's up high. Picks up one. Making it now a 1v3 instead of the 1v4. Can he grab an ace and can he finish it off to make it 6-2?
Still plenty of time. A minute remaining in this round. But the bomb is down in such an open position that you got to wonder what Chillian's options are. Has to try and at least get two more kills. Oh, he does spot one player. Exo's up, but he's going to get tagged and killed from the player chilling at the back of the court side. There's always been a Mindfreak player there for the past two consecutive defensive rounds. So well played by them. Shucks, using that bow to perfection. Okay, maybe not to perfection. There was a few warning shots there, but he finalized a kill in the end there. I'm worried now, because that's two consecutive rounds that Mindfreak have won, and I don't want your prediction to actually happen.
Oh, that's not very nice. Well, but 5-3 the score becomes, and Mindfreak, they want to end it here. They want to try and get these last
few
rounds. They want five in a row.
Yeah.
Five rounds in a row, and they'll be ecstatic. But looking at this right now, it's a hard, it's a very quick one. But look at this defensive side coming out. Buzzin again. During those last few rounds, Buzzin's sniper shot wasn't that good, but now he's picked it up in the last two or three. And like that again, it's a 1v4. Beaston, though, this time around. He'll find one on Shock. Second one down there, too. He's got to watch out for Buzzin on the distance with that scope. If he pops out too far, he will get picked up. I think that he's going to be aware perhaps they are wrapping, and he's going to perhaps look back around and check if he can get across there quickly. Of course, with Exo, you can dash across to each bomb site very quickly, but that bomb is going down, and it looks like this, again, might be a Mindfreak round.
Yeah, he was just scouting out the A bomb site there. No success on spotting any of the players here. And with a bow in a situation like this, you don't expect much to happen, but he does get a nice little headshot on Fighter. So the numbers advantage is slowly dwindling for Mindfreak, but can he get the second player, or the third one, should I say? Buzzo actually tagged up really heavy. Should be able to finalize this. Can he actually 1v4 this? Now, did he spot Dent? I don't think he did.
Look at this geek spot.
That's pretty nerdy by Denz there. 5-7. Can he clutch up for his team? Oh, long range shots. Hits Beaston. Beaston knows roughly where he is, but he's got to stick to that bomb with 11 seconds left. Well played by the grenade. Dwindling down the clock there. I'm scared now.
I always get scared when you know they're on the bomb defusing and you have to cook a nade. Because if that nade hits anything, then you've just lost that round. Like
That was perfect.
It was.
Did you? That was perfect.
Gordon Ramsay wouldn't have anything negative to say about that. But
no.
If it hit that gutter rail, it would have bounced back at him, wouldn't have got the kill, and they would have had the round.
So you're thinking about the worst possible situation.
Oh, yeah, that's just me. That's just my mind.
But this is Dent, okay? How often would Dent do something like that? They are on defensive round. We could be going to round 11.
We could. We're not just there yet, but we're getting very, very close. Of course, this has now been a very few more rounds. They've had three in a row for this Mindfreak team. They want to make it four, and perhaps, like I said, even five, but this one has been slowed down. Usually by now, there's been a pick by Mindfreak on one of the Trident players.
Well, they have so much momentum. Those three rounds have been taken from the guys at Trident. Jarzan, this is the fourth time he's managed to get that bomb down. in the same spot. Shox does take him out though with a grenade, but the fact that the bomb did get planted, it's going to force a reactionary play out of the team of Mindfreak here. Damage has to use these grenades effectively. Only scouts out the second story, not the third where the players are. Dens gets a kill here. Beasted, he's right behind him. He gets one. There's going to be two more players in front of him, but he drops and it's going to be chilling his last one alive. It's a 1v2. He's in a great position here, but he does get taken out by Dens.
Four in a row for Mindfreak.
You know what? This is what we expect from Mindfreak.
Dens, three streak there. Fighter on 9 and 7 just then? I'll have to reread it when he gets back into the game.
Are they clutching this?
Are they getting defense? I think they might have the kills after these last few rounds. They should get defense, I think, after all the switching
I don't
sides.
Even think it matters that much. The fact that they've won that many rounds in a row, they're actually on the aggressive side. Okay, so.
Look at those kills. Ooh. Look at the kills from the Trident team, though. 11-7 yes. for Beast, and damage is on 10-6. So both these teams have gone off, but Mindfreak, four in a row, can they make it five? We're about to find out.
Here we go. Dens pushing up. Want to scout out fire. Doesn't spot any of the players there.
Look at Trident.
They gambled, and it hasn't worked out, unfortunately, for them. There goes the bomb. Mindfreak in a perfect position here to make a monumental comeback and win the grand final. 35 seconds remaining in this game, potentially. Buzzo draws one kill, takes out Beastin. Dent has not moved from this position. He's going to fight Chilians. It's a 4v2. They need the two more kills to win the grand final here. What can they do? Dent, he wants to scout this out as much as he can. 20 seconds remaining. They might just have this one.
They might, as that bomb time is ticking on down. Dent swinging around behind two of the players here. One more outside. He doesn't see him. Checks the bomb. Doesn't really matter, though, because it's a 1v3.
You're kidding
and
me.
He's not going to have a chance to defend a Mindfreak. Five rounds in a row to take the series 6-2 and become your ACL Sydney for 2015 champions here for Call of Duty Advanced Warfare.
Only Mindfreak in a grand final would come back from a 5-1 deficit to win. Incredible performance out of them. Well deserved if that's the way that they're playing. Oh, God, I can't wait to see them later on in the year, especially with the MLG Championship coming up. That is a stellar performance from Mindfreak. They were on point the entire weekend, and they clutched up when it was needed.
Oh, they did indeed. And obviously, now making that score 6-2 in the series, you know, a lot of people tip different things, but in the end, it was still going to be Mindfreak. Everyone tipped Mindfreak to win, is what I'm saying. Everyone.
Yep, you can say
yeah,
it.
I was right.
You
okay.
can, yep.
I won't say it, but yeah, I was.
We
but
all
no,
know.
I'm just saying, like, everyone tipped different themes, but the same team was the one that were picked out to win. Yeah. Trident, valiant effort, you know. It was just sad they couldn't close out that SND.
Yeah.
They could have had, they could have went to the next one on Uplink Detroit, I think. Yeah, it was. So maybe it would have been on either way. I'm not too sure. Obviously, being a map like Detroit, but then a hard point Biolab. It's really hard, you know. Obviously, everyone can put a tip in and think who might close it out in the end, but it was going to be Mindfreak, and Mindfreak obviously very happy with their performance. In the end, not at the start of the weekend, though.
Yeah. They pulled their heads in.
Yeah,
that's what they did.
For the grand final, they did. For the winners' bracket final, they did as well. Yeah. So they've done what needed to be done in the end. They got here, they got the win, and they'll be very happy with themselves now, finally, after closing out the weekend.
You know who did pull their head in that S&D? Dens. He had a very shaky start. As I said, you know, almost.
Well, he was 0-3 until he got that.
Yeah, he was 0-3. He finished at the top 10-8. Got that phenomenal clutch. That is montage worthy. Expect that on the top five plays, guys. But Dens goes big for his team when it's needed. Congratulations to Mindfreak. They were the best on the day. Maybe not the first day.
No, but, second day, though.
But they definitely came here prepared for the second day championship Sunday and well-deserved. As you said, Trident, though, they made it all the way to the grand final. One of the best series we've seen from our advanced warfare competition in the Australian-New Zealand scene against Avant. Just what a way to finish the event. Those final two series, just phenomenal.
Yes, it was indeed. And we do have an interview standing by. But first, I just want to know they are standing by, so we will go over to them instead. It is going to be a maniac on the floor with your winners from Mindfreak.
Thanks very much, Bioacid and Dr. Curry. I am here with the Captain Buzzo of Plantronics Mindfreak. The winners here at the grand final of ACL Sydney's 2015 Call of Duty tournament. Buzzo, you look very calm and composed now. We have talked about you guys being a little shaky throughout the weekend, but look, you pulled through, you took out winners bracket final, and now the grand final here in an amazing style in that final S&D. First, if you can you just give me your thoughts so far on how you guys played in this final series?
The final series, we really just, the S&Ds, man, they were crazy. You know, we made two comebacks from 5-3, 5-1. Normally, we get down on ourselves a lot in Search and Destroy when we're down like that. And but to pull those comebacks, like, you know, we normally lose S&D as it is. So to make, you know, three rounds in a row and then five rounds in a row is pretty crazy.
when you saw those guys get all the way to five rounds versus the one for Plantronics.Mindfreak, what was going through your head? Did you really actually feel at that time that you could bring it back? Or was what was the morale in your squad?
Oh, like I said, I know, we sort of always tend to be down. Like, as always, you know, anyone's always down. But you just got to really sit there and think, you know, like it's happened to us before. You know, we're 5-1 up ourselves or 5-0. You just got to take every round, you know, as it comes, as it goes. Just mix it up. You know, obviously, you just got to keep doing different stuff because what you've been doing isn't working. So just literally round by round and, you know, you're clawing it back. So every round you take is, you know, taking, chipping away at their confidence. So that's the way we look at it.
I've talked about strategies with Mindfreak before, and it seems that the strategy is to win. That's the strategy. But tell me, did you actually mix anything up in that S&D, or was it just about just keeping that composed nature that really clutched it in the end?
Strat-wise, we try to play like Americans. We find that we're still stuck in a old-school sort of search and destroy style where we play for cuts across the map, whereas Americans, they play really aggressive, play for trades, play, you know, three-man pushes and one guy watching flank. They do a lot of stuff like that. So every time we play here, we play our normal style, we win, and then we go over there and we get destroyed. So we try to implement what we learn over there back here. And for some reason, it doesn't tend to work. So we sort of just went back to the old school style of just sitting there watching cuts and, you know, just playing together for trades.
And what did you think of your final opponent? Trident got all the way through the eliminated by you into the losers bracket in that winners bracket final. They obviously faced you again after taking out the losers bracket. What are your thoughts on their team? And do you think their current lineup is something to look out for in future?
Oh, yeah, well, that's the, I think it might have been 3 lands, might be 18-0. It's at least 12-0 map count against Trident. They took 2 maps off us. We weren't playing the best, but it's still, you know, 2 maps. So, you know, they took a respawn. Not many teams take respawns off of us. So they're a good team. You know, they're going to just keep, if they just keep playing, gelling with Jarzan, you know, they'll do fine, I think. They've got a solid team, so.
All right, I won't keep you much longer. No doubt you want to celebrate with your team. Lastly, Buzzo, I just want to give you the opportunity to give a shout out to anyone, whether sponsors or otherwise, who would help you get to this event. Tell me, who would you like to give a shout out to?
We got, obviously, Mindfreak. We got Plantronics, Games, Scuff Gaming, Docs, Derek. We got Albert and Pulse. You know, they all help us out doing, you know, the behind the scenes sort of stuff. So cheers to them.
Awesome. Well, congratulations once again.
And to you guys for doing an amazing effort, as always.
Appreciate it, Buzzo. Thank you very much. Well, look, congratulations once again to you and your team, Plantronics.Mindfreak, your champions here of the Call of Duty tournament at ACL Sydney 2015. Thank you very much. And guys, for you at home, that is going to wrap up the stream here from ACL Sydney. I'd like to give a big shout out to all of you guys for tuning in. Thank you very much. We appreciate your support here from all of the people here at ACL. I'd also like to show some love once more to our sponsors, Astro, BenQ, HyperX, Corsair, Domino's, and of course DX Racer. Thank you very much for all of your support. We love you guys. Make sure you follow us on Twitter at ACL Pro. The hashtag for this event was ACL Sid. You can check out ACL Pro video for all of the VODs that will be coming from ACL Sydney and future events. For now, I've been Maniac. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll see you guys next time.